Okay, the test we're going to perform now is a flow plate test to get system airflow through our central heating and cooling system. Flow plate's kind of a generic name for a device such as this. This is probably the best known, which is the Energy Conservatory True Flow flow plate. This is the smaller of the two plates. And as you might recall, this plate works on principle of air moving across this device. There's holes here. There's little sensing, pressure sensing taps on both the front and the back of the plate. And when we hook it up to our pressure gauge, we can convert it into cubic feet per minute, or CFM. So there's a couple parts to this test. The first part is to actually come up with what we call the normal system operating pressure. System, well, usually we measure on the supply side. You could also call it supply operating pressure. But for that purpose, we'll use our static pressure tap. It has little holes on the side. So we're going to place our static pressure tap up in our supply plumb to get a of our normal system operating pressure in normal system operating pressure. And this is just with our standard filter in, as though we weren't going to actually do any additional testing. So we're going to hook up to our pressure tap, up to our gauge, I should say, turn it on. Conventionally, just go on the, you know, the input side with this gauge, on the A side, I should say, turn it on. So we have our air going in, and coming out the top, and we have an NSOP of about, it's about 57 pascals. So now, I'll just take out my system filter. This is a kind of flimsy tin filter cover, but it's my filter. And I'm going to temporarily replace it with my flow plate. Now, there is a front and a back. The front, meaning the place where the air will hit first, and it's easy to tell on these devices. The labels are on the front. The little holes have a kind of a depression on the front. The hoses come out of the front. So, air is going in. We're hitting this side first. Sometimes getting the hoses out without crushing them is part of the challenge, but you usually find a way. You might replace the actual cover temporarily with some tape. You just want to make a seal there so you don't, you're not losing anything airflow wise. Now this plate doesn't need any extra spacers inside. It fills the whole opening, but it does come with a set of spacers. You can make your own spacers as well. All you have to do is make a good enough connection to the main plate to get all the air to go through the plate and not have any go around the edges. If it goes around the edges, you're not going to be able to measure it, and you're going to get an artificially low flow. All right. So now, before I connect up to the plate, I'm going to re-measure my supply static pressure. I didn't have to do anything other than replace the filter with the plate. Didn't have to move this. It has a magnet to keep it on. All I do is look back at the number on the gauge. In this case, it's moving around a little bit, but around 74 or 75 pascals. I'll just choose 74. The abbreviation we use for this is TFSOP for true flow system operating pressure. Pascals. The purpose of doing this is that, or taking the two measurements up there, is that the flow plate is a different device from the filter. It can affect the amount of air the air handler moves. It acts like a different filter, if you want to think of it that way. If we don't keep track of that effect, we're going to not know for sure what our flow is when we put the filter back in. By taking this second measurement, we can actually make a one-step correction using the tables that the manufacturer provides. We'll get to that in a minute in detail. Now, I have to actually measure the pressure drop across the plate. The way I do that is by hooking up the hoses. The hose order is not important, meaning you can put the green on the bottom or on the top. This value here will not change, but you'll get a minus sign, or the minus sign will go away. So what we call the plate pressure looks to be about 31 pascals, maybe a little more, 31.5. We'll call that the plate pressure. Now we're ready to actually get to a flow and a correction. The plate we put in was the number 14 plate. Okay. So we have our measurements. All that's left is to look up the what we call the raw flow, which is what came off of from our plate pressure and our plate size, which was the number 14. Here we were kind of in between 31 and 32 pascals of plate pressure. So a flow between about 640 and 650 CFM. Well, let's call it 645. And as you recall, we had a difference in NSOP and TFSOP. The manufacturer provides a set of correction tables. Across the top, they'll list the NSOP, and across the side, the TFSOP. We were not exactly on these, but we were awfully close, and we'll be within a couple percent by using this value. If you want to get very exact, you can actually use this formula, but you got to have your square root key handy on your calculator. But our correction factor, in this case, is number around 0.86. That means we will multiply our correction factor by our raw flow. And that will give us the corrected system flow. These two numbers together, using the chart, give us a correction factor about 0.86. Our raw flow from these two numbers together was about 645 CFM. Call it our, these two together give us this raw flow. Again, from looking it up, the product of these two values, the off-screen handoff. 645 times 0.86 equals 555 CFM. Corrected flow. The reason, again, we have to go through this process is the true flow device often will create different resistance for the air handler than the system filter. By taking our normal system operating pressure before we put the plate in and taking that same pressure in the same position with the plate in, we can make one mathematical correction to our raw flow reading. In practice, every system is different. In many cases, the correction factor is greater than one. Also, in quite a few cases, there is very little difference, and the correction factor is very close to one and is not worth worrying about. This is especially true with the newer types of variable speed air handlers, which change their RPM to adjust to different types of filters or other obstructions to maintain very, very consistent flows. So whether you have a filter or a flow plate in there, you're going to see a very similar flow because of how that controller works. On older style permanent split capacitor fans like we have here, we tend to see correction factors diverging away from one much more often. So, very important to take both these numbers and use them as necessary to make corrections to the raw flow reading from the plate.